the Thermalright heatsink, one of the most asked about heatsinks for the PlayStation 5 internal SSD. Will this fit inside the PlayStation 5? That's what we're going to find out real quick. Thanks for stopping by my channel. And if you're new to the channel, you can always go ahead and hit the subscribe, hit the like, and share this video with everybody. Alright, what I got before you today is a Thermalright heatsink. This is a 2280, this is the regular type, and this is the 2280, the Pro Edition. You can pick both of them up from Amazon, I'll leave the link in the description. Both of them are for the size that's recommended for the PlayStation 5. The dimensions are 75mm by 22.7mm by 11.7mm. And they all come with the material built with the aluminum alloy. And both the colors are gray, and with Thermalright, it comes with a 1-year warranty. So, the question has been asked, will it fit inside the PlayStation 5? That's what we're going to find out real quick. So first thing first, it's going to be a very quick video, so let's unbox them real quick. So this is the first one right here. This is the regular model. And I can tell right off the jump, I tried it before, I like them very much. They are very elegant looking heat sinks. So this is it right here. Bring it up closer to you so you can see. Awesome, beautiful design. With the screws at the side. Beautiful. That's the regular edition. And let's go with the Pro. Let's see what the Pro looks like. I never had a Pro before. Yo, I like this design. Kind of like an arrow. I don't know what to describe, but this design is beautiful. Look at it. Let me go closer. You can see it's an M2 Pro. Nice, shiny, and everything. So, what I'm going to do real quick, I'm not going to waste time and put an internal SSD because nothing's going to change. But one thing I can let you know, these are low profile heat sink, so they're going to fit perfectly. Now, the question is, with the width and with the screws on the side, will it fit without any problem? Do we have to remove the screws so it could fit inside the PlayStation 5? That's what we're going to find out right now. All right, here am I going to do the fit test to see if it fit inside the PlayStation 5. And it's not too late for you to go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Right here, both of them screws out. So this, boom. So what we get right here? It's a low profile, so it will fit right inside the PlayStation 5, and it will close. It will close with the lid on. The only difference is the screws making it a little bit with the screws on the side, it won't fit perfectly, but. Unfortunately, you're gonna have to remove screws on one side of the heatsink, but you don't have to worry because see, it still holds perfectly firm. And the thermal padding is already of an adhesive, so it will hold the internal SSD into place, so it won't go anywhere. So see, the trick with the Thermalright, they have excellent heatsinks. They keep everything cool, but you're just gonna have to remove the screws on either side of your choosing. So let's go with the regular one right here. Same thing. I'm gonna remove the screws on this one again. You see, it makes the same difference. Oops, the first one, show you right here real quick. Like I said, this is gonna be a very short video. You can always go ahead and share with everybody who thinks you can get in the Thermalright. This is the second one. Boom, perfect. With the lid on, I see there's an issue. No issue, it fits right into place. And to show y'all, the PlayStation screw, you can see the logo, the screw, the circle, the X, the triangle, the square. So, this heatsink will fit perfectly inside the PlayStation 5 with the lid on. Only the issue is, unfortunately, you're gonna have to remove the screws on either side of your choosing, and it will fit inside. Let me show you right here. Let me try the pull test. Right here, it won't go anywhere. It will hold firm. So, don't be discouraged. These are excellent heatsinks. Very excellent. They get very high marks on the websites I checked out. So, I'll go ahead and buy these, and they're very affordable. So, that's it for y'all today. Like I said, it's going to be a very brief video. I appreciate y'all coming through. And for the viewers that asked me to do the fit test, I did it for y'all. And if this video is going to help anybody else, I appreciate it as well. Thank you guys for tuning in. I'll catch you in the next one.